Check. So welcome everyone to the webinar, especially from our Diadami. So myself Mahima. So today I will be taking up the webinar especially on golden rules to score more than 350 plus in geography options. So after seeing it up, सबको लग रहा होगा, is it possible or not? कैसे हो सकता है 350 plus? नहीं सुना कभी, बट यस इट्स पॉसिबल, हम कर सकते हैं. वी कैन स्कोर मोर देन 350 प्लस इन ऑप्शनल्स. कैसे? तो लेट्स सी. हमेशा हमें ध्यान रखना है किसी भी प्रिपरेशन में, व्हेनेवर वी गो फॉर एनी प्रिपरेशन, यू हैव टू सी फर्स्ट व्हाट यू कॉल्ड एज द सिलेबस. सिलेबस प्लेस अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रोल इन your preparation, right? As we all belong to a different background, some are from the arts background, some are from the geography background, some are from the science background, and some are from your what you called as arts and political, every background. Uske liye sabse pehle we need what? We need that syllabus pata hona chahiye hame geography optionals ka. What is the topics given in it? What is how we have to go for it, right? So बिना syllabus पढ़े हम कभी भी preparation नहीं कर सकते. That is more important. Now secondly, syllabus देखो. Syllabus देखने के बाद, see what is there in syllabus. You know that there is paper one and there is paper two. In paper one, we are focusing on physical geography and human geography, and then we have paper two, where we focus on Indian geography. So, ab mind mein clear ho gaya ki yes, syllabus hai. We have to read these things. Ab syllabus ka heading hai. Aur aage chalte hain. Aur kya hai iske andar? Now, ek geography ka physical geography ke baad andar ek topic aa gaya, geomorphology. Meko ek aur mil gaya. That is geomorphology, right? So, aapko iske andar ye sab material tayar karna hai. You see a geomorphology? You see origin and evolution of Earth's crust. Now see next, what is there? It's physical conditions, right? And then we see what you called as other things also. So आपको हर syllabus के आपने उसके core में जाना है, ठीक है? उसके themes में, उसके topics को देखना है. See over here, it is economic geography. तो आपको इकोनॉमिक ज्योग्राफी के अंदर के पोर्शंस देखने. सो मेन थिंग इट ऑल सी कि हमें पहले अंदर जाना है, राइट? ज्यूमोफोलॉजी है, क्लाइमेटोलॉजी है, ओशनोग्राफी है, कुछ भी है, सबसे पहले वी हैव टू सी द थीम स्पेशली. अब यहां देखो चैनल मॉर्फोलॉजी भी है, फंडामेंटल जियोमैग्नेटिज्म भी है. हर चीज का थीम को पकड़ना है और थीम को पकड़ के हमें आंसर को देखना है. तो सबसे पहले हम सिलेबस को रटेंगे, उसको मेमोराइज करेंगे. Why I am saying to memorize the syllabus? क्योंकि suppose I read some what you call it social media पे मैं गई, या I am reading some newspapers, so and then I come to know कि अरे मेरा टॉपिक ज्यूमोफोलॉजी के अंदर मुझे चैनल मॉर्फोलॉजी करना है. यहाँ मुझे ये कोट बहुत अच्छी लगी, so I just pick that quote. I got some diagram very interesting, so I just click the pick and mereko apne answer mein lagana hai. So without knowing the syllabus, we will not be able to make it up, right? So, सबसे पहले syllabus के पीछे भागो, syllabus को याद करो. This is climatology है, oceanography है, biography है, environmental geography है, perspective in human geography है, economic geography है हमारी human geography में, population and settlement geography है, regional planning है, models है, and then we come to Indian geography also. इंडियन ज्योग्राफी में हमें फिजिकल सेटलिंग पढ़ना है, हमें रिसोर्सेज पढ़ने हैं इंडिया के, हमें एग्रीकल्चर पढ़ना है, इंडस्ट्री पढ़नी है, ट्रांसपोर्ट, कल्चरल सेटिंग, सेटलमेंट्स, रीजनल प्लानिंग, पॉलिटिकल एस्पेक्ट्स एंड कंटेम्पररी इश्यूज. तो एक मुझे जस्ट मिल गया मेरे माइंड में कि मुझे क्या करना है, मुझे सिलेबस देखना है. दिस इज द गोल्डन रूल जो हम सब मिस कर देते हैं. हम भाग रहे हैं इधर उधर 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 भागने के लिए, नहीं, मेक इट अ हैबिट, मेक अ सिलेबस एंड वॉल पे लगा दो. इससे बढ़िया बात क्या है. डेली अगर हाथ में अगर याद नहीं हो रहा, टाइम लगेगा थोड़ा सा, बट कीप इट ऑन द वॉल, यू कैन मेमोराइज इट एंड उससे आपको याद होगा कि मुझे क्या पढ़ना है. ठीक है, सो दिस इज द फर्स्ट गोल्डन रूल. नाउ सेकेंड, अरे बाबा सिलेबस तो देख लिया, लेट अस कवर अप विद द प्रीवियस ईयर क्वेश्चन पेपर्स ऑल्सो. मैं आज सपोज आई टेल यू कि हम जोमोफोलॉजी पढ़ रहे हैं और मैं जोमोफोलॉजी में कुछ ऐसा टॉपिक पढ़ रही हूँ जिसकी क्वेश्चंस बहुत कम है. सपोज आई गिव जस्ट रफली गिविंग इट अप, सपोज अगर एनवायरनमेंट से तो सबसे ज्यादा क्वेश्चन आ रहे हैं, क्लाइमेटोलॉजी से बहुत क्वेश्चन आ रहे हैं, तो व्हाई शुड आई वेस्ट माय टाइम रीडिंग दोस टॉपिक जहां पे मुझे कुछ नहीं मिलेगा. मुझे ऐसे टॉपिक पढ़ने हैं जहां पे मुझे कुछ मिलेगा, राइट? सो हमें इसको स्ट्रेस करना है प्रीवियस ईयर क्वेश्चंस को पढ़ के कि या आई विल रिस्ट्रिक्ट माय सेल्फ ओनली टू दोस सिलेबस से. मेरे को सिलेबस मैच करना है अपने प्रीवियस ईयर क्वेश्चन से और देखो किस किस यूनिट से, किस टॉपिक से मेरे ज्यादा क्वेश्चन आ रहे हैं. तो आई विल प्रिपेयर, प्रिपेयर तो करना है सब कुछ, बट इतना कुछ भी प्रिपेयर नहीं करना, उसको शॉर्ट डाउन करना अपने सिलेबस को. वी हैव टू मर्ज, इतना नहीं पढ़ो, इतना पढ़ो, इतना रिस्ट्रिक्ट कर दो अपने आप को कि यू डोंट फाइंड इट डिफिकल्ट फॉर स्टडीज, राइट? Everyone have a myth ki yaar geography is having a very lengthy syllabus, how will I be able to cover it up, so many things, that no, there is a strategy for it. You have to go for a smart work, never go for going for following anyone. Make your own strategy, make your smart studying, that is more important in any exam for qualifying. And especially I declare, I everyone says that ye kaisa exam hai, ye aisa exam hai that is called as mother of all exams, right? So mother of all exams है, तो उसकी strategy भी उसी के हिसाब से होनी चाहिए, उसी हिसाब से preparation भी होनी चाहिए. हर बंदा life में hard work करता है, बिना hard work के कुछ नहीं होता. But upcoming this technological world, you have to go for a smart work also. So I will suggest in our preparation, this is a golden rule, previous year question paper. अब यहाँ भी हम लोग गलती करते हैं previous year question paper में, पढ़ तो रहे हैं. हम क्वेश्चन को पढ़ने में बड़ी गलती करते हैं. यहाँ लिखा हुआ है डिस्क्राइब फ्रेटिक इरप्शंस एंड देयर कॉन्सिक्वेंसेस. ओके, डिस्क्राइब करना है, कई बार आप वर्ड सुनोगे इलैबोरेट करना है, कहीं वर्ड सुनोगे उसको क्रिटिक दे दो, कोई वर्ड सुनोगे इलस्ट्रेट कर दो. सो सी द लाइन प्रॉपरली व्हाट द क्वेश्चन इज डिमांडिंग, दिस इज मोर इम्पोर्टेंट. देन वी कैन प्ले विद हाउ टू गो फॉर इट, व्हाट द क्वेश्चन डिमांड्स. बिना क्वेश्चन को ढंग से पढ़े हुए डोंट अटेम्प्ट एनी क्वेश्चन, राइट? सो प्रीवियस ईयर हमें देता है कि क्या पूछ रहा है, वो पूछ रहा है हाउ, दे पूछ रहा है डिस्क्राइब. सो 2019 का पेपर है, सो दिस इज हाउ दे गोइंग इट अप. अब प्रीवियस ईयर में मुझे पता चल गया कि मुझे जो पेपर टू है उसके अंदर मुझे क्या करना है. मुझे पेपर टू के एक कंपल्सरी क्वेश्चन है मैप का, वो आ रहा ही आ रहा है, मैं उसको 10 नंबर क्यों ना स्कोर करूं. सो आई हैव टू स्कोर दैट 10 मार्क्स, दैट इज माय प्लस पॉइंट. सो लेट अस वर्क ऑन दैट, लेट अस वर्क ऑन मैपिंग. मैपिंग बहुत सारी है, या आई एग्री बहुत सारी है, उसकी भी टेक्निक होती है याद करने की. दैट इज व्हाट आई एम टेलिंग यू अगेन एंड अगेन, गो विद द स्ट्रेटजी, गो विद द प्लान, राइट? दिस इज द सेकंड गोल्डन रूल. नाउ द नेक्स्ट गोल्डन रूल, वी कम टू एनसीईआरटीज एंड रेफरेंस बुक. Oh my God, NCERT, ये देखो कितनी सारी बुक्स की लिस्ट. फिजिकल ज्योग्राफी, माय गॉड, बाय स्ट्रेलर, बाय थॉर्नबरी, मेड सिंपल, बोनार्ड डायग्राम्स, नाउ सी द क्लाइमेटोलॉजी लिस्ट, माय गॉड, ओशनोग्राफी, बायोग्राफी, इकोनॉमिक की अलग बुक है, पॉपुलेशन कितनी बुक है, एनवायरमेंट पे कितनी बुक है, ओ तो क्या मुझे ये सब पढ़ना है, क्या मुझे ये सारी करनी पड़ेंगी, इतनी सारी बुक्स, इतनी सारी बुक्स पढ़ूंगा तो कैसे चलेगा, मैं तो सिलेबस बहुत ज्यादा हो गया। नहीं, यू हैव टू अगेन रिस्ट्रिक्ट योर सेल्फ ओवर हियर, इतना नहीं पढ़ना, इतना पढ़ो जितना हमारा सिलेबस क्लियर हो सके। सो व्हाट वी हैव टू गो, वी हैव टू ओनली स्टडी द एनसीईआरटी फ्रॉम 6 to 10, द ओल्ड वन। अब ये ओल्ड वन एनसीईआरटी क्या होती है, अब ये न्यू वन एनसीईआरटी क्या होती है, सिंपल, द बुक्स विच वर पब्लिश्ड बिफोर 2000 दे आर कॉल्ड द ओल्ड एनसीईआरटी, एंड द बुक्स विच आर पब्लिश्ड आफ्टर 2000 आर नोन एज न्यू एनसीईआरटी, राइट। सो 6 to 10 को हमें ओल्ड एनसीईआरटी में पढ़ो, एंड 11th and 12th हमें न्यू एनसीईआरटी में पढ़ना है। दिस इज द स्ट्रैटेजी, राइट। आगे चलते हैं, अब हमें जाना है फिजिकल ज्योग्राफी, क्योंकि फिजिकल ज्योग्राफी में काफी क्वेश्चन है। वी आर हैविंग द सविंदर सिंह बुक, दैट इज गुड, उनकी अलग अलग इंडिविजुअल बुक भी अवेलेबल है। यू आर हैविंग जियोमॉर्फोलॉजी बुक बाय सविंदर सिंह, यू आर हैविंग क्लाइमेटोलॉजी बुक बाय सविंदर सिंह। सो रिस्ट्रिक्ट या तो उनकी पूरी वाली या डिफरेंट डिफरेंट वाली, राइट। नाउ वी कम टू द नेक्स्ट बुक, दिस इज फिजिकल एंड ह्यूमन ज्योग्राफी बाय जी सी लियोंग, इट्स वेरी फेमस अमंग द स्पेशली द यूपीएससी एस्पिरेंट्स फॉर योर जीएस प्रिपरेशन। यू विल शॉक टू नो दैट इन ज्योग्राफी जितना क्वेश्चन हमारा ऑप्शंस में है, सम क्वेश्चंस ओवरलैप टॉपिक्स आर देयर इन योर जीएस मेंस आल्सो, सो इट्स बेटर वी कैन गो फॉर इट, राइट। सो गो फॉर ह्यूमन ज्योग्राफी प्रिपरेशन एंड बाय जी सी लियोंग। वी हैव ह्यूमन ज्योग्राफी बाय मार्टिन सेन सर, रेनॉल्ड राइटर, यू कैन सजेस्ट हिज बुक, रीड हिज बुक। आई एम सजेस्टिंग द लिमिट ऑफ द बुक, डोंट रीड टू मच, आई एम अगेन पॉइंटिंग आउट, डोंट रीड टू मच, जस्ट रिस्ट्रिक्ट योर सेल्फ, दैट इज मोर इम्पोर्टेंट। नेक्स्ट, मॉडल्स एंड थ्योरीज बाय माधव सेन सर एंड ज्योग्राफिकल थॉट बाय आर डी दीक्षितर एंड इंडियन ज्योग्राफी बाय खुल्लर, दैट्स इट, दैट्स मोर इम्पोर्टेंट। लास्ट एंड नॉट द लीस्ट, इन ज्योग्राफी बिना एटलेस, बिना मैप्स के कुछ नहीं होगा। So, Orion Black Swan's Atlas and Oxford Atlas, these are the two renowned atlas which you have to follow for your optional preparation of geography. Three golden rules. Let's come for the next one. Answer writing practice. This is very, very important thing. Everyone miss writing answers. हमने पढ़ लिया, बहुत कुछ आता है, हो गया, अब हम नहीं लिखेंगे. No. Geography या यूपीएससी ये नहीं मांगता कि आप आंसर मत लिखो, बिकॉज विदाउट राइटिंग एनी आंसर आपको पता नहीं चलेगा कि हाउ मच आई हैव लर्न्ड एंड हाउ मच आई कैन पुट इनटू माय आंसर। कैसे? सपोज इन एन आंसर राइटिंग आई गिव यू एन एग्जांपल, लाइक मेरे को एक टॉपिक था वोल्केनो, वोल्केनो के ऊपर, एंड वोल्केनो हाउ इट वाज फॉर्म, व्हाट आर इट्स कॉन्सिक्वेंसेस, हाउ कैन वी लीडिंग इट अप। अब इस आंसर के अंदर आई हैव सम रफ आइडिया कि इंट्रो है, कुछ वॉल्केनो कैसे इराप्ट हुआ, क्या कॉन्सिक्वेंसेस लिखते हैं। स्टार्टिंग में व्हेन यू आर राइटिंग एनी आंसर, यू विल टेक 15 मिनट्स, यू कैन टेक 20 मिनट्स टू राइट दैट आंसर, बट आई डोंट हैव अ टाइम इन माय एग्जाम, आई हैव अ वेरी लिमिटेड टाइम, और मेरा माइंड इतना तेज होना चाहिए उस टाइम, मुझे क्विक क्विक आई हैव टू राइट द आंसर। सो बिना आंसर राइटिंग प्रैक्टिस के आप ये नहीं कर पाएंगे। This is again the golden rule. What? You have to write an answer properly. Pen down every day, if possible. Pen down every day one answer. Zyada ho gaya, then go for two answers. But pehle likhna shuru karo. Because in exam, 6.5 or 7 minutes is more than enough. Nahi ho paega agar hum karenge nahi to. 6.5 minutes में हमें एक आंसर लिखना है, और उस आंसर की प्रैक्टिस विदाउट आंसर राइटिंग प्रैक्टिस एट होम, इट्स नॉट एट ऑल पॉसिबल, राइट। दिस इज अनदर गोल्डन रूल विच इज मोर इम्पोर्टेंट, राइट। अब आंसर राइटिंग लिख रहे हो, आंसर राइटिंग में भी ये नहीं है कि आज लिखा छोड़ दिया, हो गया भाई, हो गया, नहीं, ऐसे कैसे हो जाएगा। यू हैव टू मेंटेन योर डिसिप्लिन ओवर देयर, यू हैव टू मेंटेन योर टाइम ओवर देयर, you have to maintain the consistency and you have to maintain what is called as mind map. Discipline lana apni life mein bahut zaruri hai. It's very important if you go for a discipline. If you're not disciplined, if you are sitting on one day, I will write an answer, and other day you decided, no, I will not be going for any answer writing. You will not land nowhere. After giving an exam, and you say in mains I was not able to write. You know that every preparation in every exam, when you're writing it up, you have to complete the paper, not leave any single question that is more important. How it will come? You have to maintain your speed, and for that speed, for completing your paper, you need a discipline. That is more important. Be a disciplined person. Agar aaj mujhe ek answer likhna hai, I have restricted myself ki I will be sitting at 10 o'clock in the morning writing each answer for geography. Then at that time, you have to write it up. Second comes the time. Time bahut zaruri hai. Answer writing, I told you. 6.5 minutes, 7 minutes, hardly this much time we are having for writing an answer. So maintain your time. Manage your time for answer writing also. And consistency. Bina consistency ke nahi hoga. Then we come to mind map. Ye mind map kya hota hai? See, in psychology, I have learned without linking anything, you can't write an answer. Suppose you can't write an answer, means you can't think about that thing also. Like, suppose मैंने आज गाड़ी चलाने सीखी है, लर्न हाउ टू राइट व्हाट यू कॉल्ड एज ड्राइव अ कार, एंड इट्स ऑलवेज इन योर माइंड. स्टार्ट होगा, इनिशियल देंगे, देन वी गो फॉर गियरिंग इट अप, फर्स्ट गियर डाला, दिस इन योर माइंड इट हैज बीन क्रिएटेड, दिस थिंग विल डू इट अप. सो फॉर एनी ज्योग्राफी ऑल्सो ट्राई टू मेक अ माइंड मैप ऑफ अ पर्टिकुलर टॉपिक. If this is geography, we are having what you call as Indian geography, and I am studying rivers. So this is my river. A river, this is a peninsula river, this is a Himalayan river. Kahan se originate hui? How they have been originated? And what are its tributaries? This what it means of mind map. So play with a mind map. Draw your things. Map mein banana shuru karo. I told you, whenever you see something around, that is more important. माइंड मैप नहीं होगा तो आप बना नहीं पाओगे अपने आंसर्स को. सो दिस इज ऑल्सो अ प्लस पॉइंट, अ गोल्डन रूल फॉर योर आंसर राइटिंग. माइंड मैपिंग इज मोर इम्पॉर्टेंट. नाउ लेट्स कम टू द नेक्स्ट, डायग्राम्स एंड फ्लो चार्ट्स. यस, डायग्राम्स एंड फ्लो चार्ट्स के बिना ज्योग्राफी आंसर विल बी इनकम्प्लीट. लाइक वी से नाउ प्रेजेंटेशन, व्हेन वी गो टू एनी रेस्टोरेंट or we go to any anywhere, what do we see? Good presentation. When I go to five star hotel like Aerocity or some like in Pullman, whatever is there, oh my god, there is I eat over there, what do you call that, a beetroot pasta. I was shocked about this ingredient, what is there in beetroot pasta, and over there they have been very much beautifully presented on the plate and how they brought it up, and they have served. So after seeing it up, I was feeling greedy, let me eat it up and taste it, right? This is how the presentation happens. So why not we can give a presentation in our geography answer? Oh ma'am, so many content is there, how can I go? Okay, no issues, let's draw diagrams, let's make a flow chart. Put that content of 6.5 minutes, you have to write an answer. Let's write it in the form of flow charts and diagrams. See how it will be comfortable so much that you can draw it up and score more marks. Bina presentation ke to bhai jo paper check karne wala teacher ya examiner hai, aur agar maine usko see in the picture you are seeing what you call as a volcano, and a volcano banaya kahan se, magma is operated, it says earth crust and ash layers and everything I have pointed out in the diagram, it looks so beautiful. So that means it's a golden rule for scoring marks in geography. Put in one answer at least 2 to 3 diagrams. It is possible. I will show you how it's possible. Everything is possible, right? Flow charts, see diagrams. Suppose I have some Himalayan rivers and peninsula rivers, or these are the ranges, especially. So if the question comes regarding ranges, just put down in the diagram now. Draw a diagram for that Karakoram range, Ladakh range. If you are having the Himalayas, then put that in your diagram presentation. This is how ek number bhi bahut keemti hai UPSC mein. It matters, one mark. Why can't I score a good mark in that? How can I get that one mark extra from the rest of the crowd? That's why I said 350, a golden rule. Kaise banaye? This is how you make your answers. Now, geography hai. Background of geography, ma'am, ye kya kaam karegi? Kyun nahi karegi? This will also play a golden rule. How? I'll tell you an example. I am a traveler. I love to travel a lot. I visit from here to here, different states, different countries. I love a lot. So when I move from one country, from one state to another, so I see in between what is all happening. What is all happening in the sense, which borders I have crossed? What NH highways I have crossed or what state highways I have crossed? So, the background of geography na. मेरे को एक ट्रैवलर होने के बाद आई गॉट एन एडवांटेज दैट आई कैन यूज दैट नॉलेज ऑफ माइंड इन माय आंसर राइटिंग यू नेवर नो वी हैव सीन अ लॉट ऑफ हॉट स्प्रिंग्स अराउंड वी हैव हर्ड अबाउट इट सो यूटिलाइज दैट इन योर आंसर सो एक बचपन की जो कला थी ट्रैवलिंग की सो दैट हेल्प मी आउट इन माय आंसर्स आल्सो सो दिस इज व्हाट background of geography is important. You should know about it. कहाँ से है, क्या मैं उस background के साथ utilize कर सकता हूँ, या what is how it has involved the things. So this makes a golden rule. अब जैसे very much interested seeing biomes, different biomes हैं. And now you see we are on a plain area and we are going uphill. So oxygen हो गया कम. और कौन कौन से बायोम्स में आप यू कैन सी कि कौन कौन सी वेजिटेशन ग्रो हो सकती है राइट इट्स अ गोल्डन रूल मतलब आपको खुद अपने बैकग्राउंड की नॉलेज लेते हुए आंसर के अंदर भी पुट करना है सो क्यों नहीं पुट करें हम लोग नाउ नेक्स्ट कम द अदर गोल्डन रूल ज्योग्राफी पेपर वन एंड पेपर टू गिव इक्वल वेटेज एंड इक्वल टाइम टू बोथ द पेपर That is more important. Don't restrict reading only paper one. Why I'm saying this? Because paper one is very conceptual, right? Some people find very interesting in writing the concepts and writing an answer and getting it up. But what is the other thing? As paper two is very theoretical, they give less time over there. Yeah, Indian geography, yeah. My God, itna sara kaise, how can I manage it up? How I have to learn the rivers? How I have to do? It's all content, it's blah, blah, blah. Because a content aapko diya jaye aur itna lengthy ho, so no one is able to solve it up. So that is an issue. So don't go for it. Na. In paper two, make it a smart thing. How can you make it smart? You just make a diagram. You can make a flow charts. And then learn that paper two. Make that theoretical part something into smart studies. So, kyun nahi yaad hoga? So, don't give time specially to paper one. Give equal time to what you called as to your paper two also. Equally, if you divide the time, that is more important. Without dividing the time and without dividing the paper equally, you will land nowhere, right? So equally give the time to both the papers. Now see, these are the papers, how a person has written an answer. You're saying, na ma'am, you're saying, how can I put the diagrams, how it's possible. See, a student has made a paper, solved his paper with the help of a color also, making it such a presentable. And what is this? In the light of plate tectonics, explain the distribution of volcanoes. This is the question. So start with the everything has what? The intro, the body, and the conclusion. You know, this is a standard format of writing any answer. And now, what we are doing over here? We just are putting a volcano is there. We note some little bit, a statement. What is a volcano? It's a kind of pipe between a magma chamber or the earth's surface through which the gases, the lava, and the solid material are ejected. Just give a statement and then draw a diagram. Now you come to know in one answer you can draw one diagram. Now they are asking how they explain the distribution of volcanoes. They have drawn another diagram of distribution of volcanoes. then you put. So this is the standard page also for writing the answer, right? So you can take a standard page of A4 sheet and make the columns. You're getting this type of notes in the market also, and then start writing your answer. See how beautiful this answer is. How can you not get one mark extra over here? This is how you have to fetch a mark from the teacher. Teacher marks nahi dega, usse lene hai. But how we will take it? With putting more effort of diagrams and flowchart in our answer writing. Now see one more question. This is sex ratio in India and its social implications. Theory par atta question lag raha. How I will be writing up? See, the person has put the what you call as the formula of the sex ratio, given the definition formula, and now they are comparing it up, giving the bar graphs also. Right? See how the answer is presented with the intro, with the graphs, with the data, with the facts. You can play with it up. Now let's come to the next one. See, they have given up the sex ratio in India, comparing it where the states it's a ratio of 2011 also, high sex ratio. Then the top 10 districts in child sex ratio portion in age group of 0 to 6. See, ek theory ka question itna zyada. How beautiful it is made. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. My God, is it possible? Yes, so the teacher has checked this paper. It is possible. But for that, again told you, practice, revise your things. That's more important. Now, one thing more which we miss in our studies, that is always geography linking with the newspaper. Don't miss it. Geography linking with the newspaper means what? These days, UPSC frame some questions which are directly linked with the newspapers. Now let's see this. How it is possible? See, there was recently a news. Yaas may become a very severe cyclone storm, very severe cyclone hit North Odisha coast. You can expect one question from here also. They can frame you. The cyclone, you can get define the cyclone. And what is the strategy for controlling it up? What methods we can now? So geography without linking newspapers, you can't write. Suppose the ecology question, your environment question, something new. Now you know that very there will be a Paris summit has all been done. A Copenhagen summit will be very soon. COP26 will be held in November. So you can utilize that data in your answer. And that data which can be utilized in your answer, it can't happen without reading a newspaper. So try to link your geography answers with the newspaper. Of newspaper, take the portions. You have some economy. You know that how the trend is. They are making geography questions with the help of economy, with the help of polity. So that environment is not there in geography because it's all about environment. Whatever you see in, around, you write in your answers. So do that. Try to read. Suppose I get one answer, one article I read regarding the strategy of what you call as how we can global warming, you must say, how we can control it, what changes we can do for controlling our sea level rise. So there can be some lines in the newspaper from where I can extract and write into my answer. So see those lines now. Read the news. Link, that's why first golden rule I'm telling you, see the syllabus, link your things, make your mind maps. That is important. Without it, nothing is possible. Bina uske UPSC clear to karni hai. But a game changer in UPSC is only the optionals. If optionals are played well, definitely our rank is great. So optionals mein 350 lane hai. 300 से अबव और 350 इनके बीच में लाना है तो ये सब तो करना ही पड़ेगा. विदाउट इट इट्स नॉट पॉसिबल. नाउ इतना पढ़ा दिया मैम, कैसे हुआ? सो डोंट एक्सर्ट योर सेल्फ इन योर एग्जामिनेशन, इन योर प्रिपरेशन. डेली यू सी सो मेनी थिंग्स इन लाइफ. Daily, you will see a new challenge, right? how every day you will feel very stressful. Every day you will feel very disheartened. Every day. So to motivate yourself, I will always tell you, go for your hobbies also. Think, what makes you happy? Today I studied so much things of geography, and over there I was stuck. Oh my God, I'm not able to learn the tributaries. I'm not able to learn these things. How can I even manage it up? So always remain positive. Always remain, try to see what you called as your hobbies. If you love driving car, go for a drive. If you love listen to music, listen to music. But do something which makes you happy, right? Gardening, love, guitar, cooking, anything which makes you happy, that is more important. Don't exert yourself with everything. Now, these are the cool rules. Yes, we have completed 10 rules, and with those 10 rules, we can achieve. आपको स्ट्रैटेजी बनानी पड़ेगी, आपको थिंग्स लिखनी पड़ेंगी. विदाउट एनी थिंग्स एंड नोट्स यू कैन डू एनीथिंग, राइट? सो सी, आई टेल यू वन थिंग, दिस A4 शीट यू हैव टू राइट एवरी डे आंसर ओवर हियर. यू हैव टू मेक योर नोट्स ओवर हियर. विदाउट मेकिंग नोट्स यू कैन डू एनीथिंग. नाउ सी हाउ वी कैन मेक एटलस इंपॉर्टेंट. Atlas is so important, no one can think about in geography. मुझे रोज कुछ नया देखना है उसके अंदर क्या हो रहा है. Now see how. Now this is an atlas. I told you there are the two famous atlases. This is Orion Blacksmith Atlas and this is Oxford School Atlas. These are two atlases which you have to follow. Atlas इतनी बड़ी है, कैसे पढ़ेंगे? ये भी बहुत important है. So हम इसको कैसे पढ़ेंगे? We will see it in this thing, right? ये geography की atlas है, and इसमें you have a Jammu Kashmir की boundaries क्या क्या है, composite river basins कौन से हैं, old desert कौन से हैं, cold desert in Kashmir. So see, एक छोटा सा आप ये लेके you can do that thing, right? This is how you can go for it. So अपनी atlases के साथ just play it up, make it a habit of keeping your atlas with you every day. Try to keep it. What you can say, you can do one thing, you can keep it at least below your pillow, right? Aur pillow mein rakh ke jab koi cheez mere mind mein nahi aa rahi, just keep it over there and solve it and see apni problem. Keep it on a wall. The Indian, the political and the physical map, world, the political and the physical map. Put those things. Write those things over there. अगर pasted होगा तो daily दिखेगा तो मुझे याद हो जाएगा, right? So you have to daily see the things over there. Without seeing daily the geography maps and everything, you will not be able to understand those things. So कुछ अटके, कुछ problem हो, just solve it at that time only. Don't cover it to the other part. Don't cover it to the next day. Solve that problem at that time, right? So these are your rules. Keep these rules in mind and you can score much better in your exam, especially in your geography, right? This is the are all golden rules for your geography. Now this is first time in India that we are working on, the Dadami team will be working on, based on 555 framework. What is this 555 framework? Kya dho rahe hain hum? Nahi. Hum answers ki strategy layenge, jisse hum answers ko achha bana payenge, right? So we are working on 5 marks maximizer tool. What is this 5 marks maximizer tool? We'll be training you how to go for micro mapping, content creation hacks, introduction hacks, and conclusion hacks, and 200 pages crux revision notes. 5 First five is for 5 marks, maximize the tool. Second five is your 50 themes. And third five is a 500 plus topic with the discussions with all the question framings, right? These are the 3 triple 5 which we are launching at Didaming. Now see, you will be asking me, what are these hacks? What is this micro mapping? Everything requires a map. You need small, small maps and techniques to solve it up. Like in the content creation hacks, we will make you like what answer you can write and how you can write that answer. Suppose I give you like in a volcano, if there a global warming situation comes, so there can be some intro facts, some maps. With those type help of that map, you can solve rest of the answers also, right? So this is what we have introduced, the hacks technique of solving the answers, so that you should not get so much burden and up, how can I go for it? How can so many things and so on? Some facts, some knowledge, basic knowledge is required for solving the some answers also. So these are the hacks techniques which we'll be using, not only in your content creation, we will be using hacks in your intro, some conclusion also, like some statement is given by some renowned, what you call it, organization also, right? So, right, organization give you, like, say, they say that Paris had
something. What you called as some new statement has been introduced in for global warming, like, so you can use that hack and write that in your conclusion that this statement is given by this, what you called as UNESCO or something like that in your geography answers also. This is how you try to improve your, what you called as answer writing. Now, this is what I told you, the 5 maximizer tools plus 50 themes through 500 plus topics. Now, what are the features of this geography course, this geography, what we have done? You should know that there is always go for the studies, I told you, as a theme-based teaching. Basics in geography are there, especially in your NCRTs. We'll be covering that. Mind maps, newspaper linking, mapping, dealing with daily with map question, covering environment portion, answer writing on daily basis, equal time to first and second paper, and after every module, a test. Doubts will be taken on regular basis and the personal attention of the students. That is more important. So this is what I mean to say, ki this is a festive time going on, right? Ek taraf Navratri hai, ek taraf Durga Puja will be coming. So in this, har jagah rang bhare jate hain. So same thing happens with your answer writing. Same thing happens with your, what you call that, preparation. Usme rang bharo. Make it colorful. Make it beautiful, right? Make every day important. Boost yourself, motivate yourself to do the things. Don't get disheartened that I will not be able to do this. Always think, yes, I can do this and I will do this. So, this is what I mean to say. This is the 10 golden rules. With the help of these, you can score much better in your optionals, and you can think it also. If you love, you can also join our course. There's a Telegram channel also. It's a contact at @didaming.com. Any other doubt, you can contact us. So thank you so much for joining and giving your precious time for this webinar. See ya from Mahima Pant and the Didaming team.